the stone that the builder refused. I am the visual, the inspiration that made ladies see the blues. I'm the spark that makes your idea bright, the same spark that lights the dark, so that you can know your love for your right.
The history of humanity is one group breaking off from another group, creating their rituals, creating their language and so on, and then walls. Let's rethink a new vision for our world, which is based on every human person is important. And that means that we all have to change.
We may think our deepest need is to be loved. Jean Vanier argues that even deeper and more universal is our desire to belong.
That we are the beloved daughters and sons of God.
Come gather round, people, wherever you roam, and admit that the waters are...
The cruiser strength of the Royal Navy in September of 1939 was something approaching 60 ships.
President Truman announced the official surrender.
That the forces of Germany have surrendered to the United Nations.
This is Henry Nouwen's Return of the Prodigal Son.
A book called Beloved. Henry Nouwen in conversation.
And a little book called The Spirituality of Fundraising.
It's also where we're at today. It's a question of bonding, of being together, of loving each other. We're not there for one group of people doing good things for another, which could be sort of generosity. But generosity must flow into a meeting, and a meeting of person to person where we love each other. When we're generous and doing things for people, we can feel we have power and we're more important. But a meeting is we become vulnerable one to another. And really, we can only become vulnerable to one another when we're in a community. And that's what Daybreak is about. You see, community really implies three things. It's a place of healing of hearts. It's a place of growth for each one of us. It's a place of celebration, and it's a place of mission or fruitfulness. Healing of hearts. Many of us, when we come to L'Arche, we have prejudice, we're frightened, we're closed in on ourselves, we lack trust in ourselves and in our deepest part of our being. So there's a whole question of healing of hearts, so that I become myself. I don't have to pretend otherwise. I don't have to show that I'm more powerful. I don't have to live in depression. It's okay. It's just okay to be myself and to know that I am loved just as myself. I don't have to prove anything. So community is a place of healing. And of course, when we live together in community, it's rather like diamonds. We're pushing on each other, and we can become brighter as we discover who we are. We discover our fears, we discover our prejudices, and then the healing is we're no longer caught up or controlled by prejudices, we're no longer controlled by fear, but we're liberated. So the healing is a gradual liberation of what is deepest within me. But community is a place of growth, because all of us, we're called to a greater maturity, a greater understanding, greater sense of responsibility. You see, in a community, Everybody is responsible. It's not just the leader, it's not just the house coordinators, it's everybody that's responsible.
I might as well say that from the very beginning. We are the beloved sons and daughters of God. And one of the enormous spiritual tasks we have is to claim that and to live a life based on that knowledge. And that's not very easy. In fact, most of us fail constantly to claim the truth of who we are.
To kind of live with yourself, let alone with other people. And I think the handicapped people become a very great challenge in the way they live, in their kind of capacity to live very fully in the present moment and to celebrate and to rejoice. And there's a real honesty about them. They live very much straightforwardly, you know, from the heart. For me, you know, I've kind of got layers of intellectualization there, and so there's a kind of stripping away that seems to be happening, and it's painful.
We are a mixture of light and darkness, and we're a mixture of strength and weakness. And if we just play on our strengths, well, then either we're going to kill people or we're going to be killed. But somewhere, if we can welcome our weakness, then we become whole. Today the strong are strong. But yesterday they were weak, they were little children. And tomorrow they'll be weak, they'll have Alzheimer's, or they'll be sick, or they'll have cancer. Because this is what society is about. It's people being born, people being strong, people dying. People who have succeeded, people who have failed. And a human society is when all these can live together in mutual recognition. And that means that we have to accept our weakness. And there is where you find somebody like Bonhoeffer saying a society can only be a society, not just where the weak need the strong, but the strong need the weak. I mean, we need to be together, because then I'll be able to accept myself as I am.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend. We've known each other since we were 9 or 10. Together we've climbed hills and trees, learned of love and ABC, skinned our hearts and skinned our knees. Goodbye, my friend, it's hard to die when all the birds are singing.